Hello, everyone, and welcome to The No Show. I'll be your host, Nathan Orenstein, and today I'm going to be reviewing The Hunger Games, The Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes. The Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes is written by Michael Leslie and Michael Arndt, directed by Francis Lawrence, and stars Tom Blythe, Rachel Zegler, Peter Dinklage, Jason Schwartzman, and Viola Davis. 10 years after they first started, The Hunger Games are starting to lose viewership and their existence is put into question. An 18-year-old Coriolanus Snow and 23 of his other classmates in the Capitol are selected to be mentors to the 24 tributes in the 10th Hunger Games, and the mentor who does the best job marketing their tribute will win a massive money prize. The Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes follows Snow's mentorship of Lucy Gray Baird and the pivotal moments in his life before and after the games. It's based on the novel of the same name and is a prequel to The Hunger Games. Full disclosure, I have not read the book this movie's based on. As a 25-year-old, I grew up in the heyday of The Hunger Games and have read those books and seen those movies, but I am unfamiliar with this new story. Okay, on with the review. So, it's 2023 and we have a new Hunger Games movie. It's been 8 years since the release of Mockingjay Part 2, and to be honest, I had kind of forgotten about the franchise as a whole. I didn't even know a new book existed. So when I saw the first trailer for this movie, I was a bit skeptical that it'd be nothing more than a cash grab preying on our nostalgia for the original series. But I'm happy to report that this is very much not that. The world of Panem, specifically the capital, looks fantastic, and it's clear that a real love and respect was put into the production design to make these sets and costumes look the best they could. The capital here really does look like it could be what the capital from The Hunger Games looked like 64 years prior. There's also very little in terms of annoying fan service here, and this is very much a prequel that could stand on its own. Yes, the main character is a key figure in the subsequent films, but knowledge of Coriolanus Snow's future is hardly a requirement to understand and even enjoy this story. Ultimately, The Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes completely justifies its existence, and it's much more than just a lazy attempt to reinsert The Hunger Games back into popular culture. Unfortunately, for me at least, this movie's story as a whole just doesn't come together well at all. I'd be willing to bet it works a lot better as a 500-page book with room to flesh the plot and characters out, rather than an overstuffed, 2.5-hour movie that manages to feel both way too long and also void of any depth. The core story is there, and I think it's good, but this film just glosses over nearly every plot point and seems intent on completely foregoing character development altogether. It starts out strongly enough in part one, and that continues for the most part into part two. Part three, though, of three, is an absolute disaster. There is so much shoehorned in this final act that the movie kind of forces you to go along with, rather than providing any meaningful explanation for what's happening. There's also a pretty abrupt change in character for Snow that feels so unearned that it genuinely frustrated me. I spent the majority of part three rolling my eyes and wishing for the film to sputter out and die, and was pretty relieved once it finally ended. I'm not sure I've ever said this before, but I think this would have greatly benefited from being two different films, in the vein of Mockingjay Part 1 and 2. Part 1 and 2 of this movie could have comprised the first film, and Part 3 could have comprised the second, giving everything a lot more room to breathe and the opportunity to be fleshed out. Instead, we're left with one of the most rushed and overly frustrating final acts I've seen in a while, and it left a pretty terrible taste in my mouth. It's not all bad though, and this movie does have its merits, the biggest for me being Viola Davis's performance as Volumnia Gall, who is the head game master of the 10th Hunger Games. This is a wild and unhinged performance, and Davis just runs with it in the most entertaining way possible. I wish there was more of her here. And I can say the same for Jason Schwartzman's performance as Lucretius Lucky Flickerman, who serves as the television host for the games. Hilarious, endlessly entertaining, and a very necessary comedic break from the very dour and, frankly, melodramatic events that unfold around him. I think Tom Blythe and Rachel Zegler each had their moments as Snow and Lucy Gray Baird respectively, even if there were elements of each of their performances that I found a bit grating. I do think their chemistry, though, specifically in the first two acts, is really great, and that whole mentor-tribute relationship, they fully sold me on it. I do mostly like how this was shot, too, with some really cool sequences in the game specifically. And like I mentioned earlier, the bones of a good story are here, and parts 1 and 2 are pretty solid and entertaining. Clearly, there is a decent amount of stuff here to like, but in my opinion, it's just not enough to overcome the writing, and honestly, a bunch of other little things here and there that I'm not even going to bother getting into. Overall, The Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes frustrated me more than it entertained me. The whole story has a lack of depth to it that honestly affects the entire film. And this shallowness culminates in a final act that feels so unearned and rushed, and frankly, crippled the film for me. But there's still a lot to like here, and I have a feeling that most people are going to enjoy this movie more than I did. For me, though, I'm going to be giving The Hunger Games: The Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes a 5 out of 10. If you enjoyed the review, then feel free to leave a like and subscribe if you're new. And if you've seen The Hunger Games: The Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes already, I'd love to hear your thoughts down in the comments below. I've been Nathan Ornstein with The No Show. Thanks for watching.